Not only is it smaller, then, it a bit chunkier on the outside, and a bit funkier on the inside, than the more elegant but understated 60 and 90 models, which is a theme you might expect to continue when smaller saloons and estates come on this platform too. The platform, or architecture, is new CMA, or compact modular architecture, they call it, and it one of two that L underpin all Volvos. The 60 and 90 models are on a different one. Here it is, for the most part, pretty conventional. It a steel monocoque, with McPherson struts at the front and a multi-link arrangement at the rear, electrically assisted steering, and transverse, front-mounted engines driving front or four wheels. Initially, all XC40s coming to the UK are four-wheel drive and have automatic gearboxes. You'll have a choice of a 187 bhp 2.0-liter diesel engine D4, or a 247 bhp 2.0-liter turbo petrol T5. Here, we've driven both, you lucky devils. As for trim levels, UK cars will be available in 7 trims ranging from Momentum through to Inscription Pro and First Edition models. Entry-level Momentum trimmed cars get LED headlights, automatic wipers and lights, rear parking sensors, 18-inch alloy wheels, cruise control plus a wealth of Volvo safety technology fitted as standard. Inside, you will find dual-zone climate control, keyless ignition, electric windows, and Volvo Sensus infotainment system complete with a 9.0-inch portrait touchscreen display, DAB radio, sat-nav, and Bluetooth and USB connectivity. Upgrade to our design and the XC40 gains a leather upholstery, LED front fog lights, gloss black exterior trim, a sporty bodykit, sport suspension and electric folding door mirrors, while the range-topping Inscription model gets driftwood interior touches, chrome highlights, ambient interior lighting, a powered tailgate, thick pile floor mats and front parking sensors. For those craving a touch more luxury can choose the Pro versions of the three previous trims, which adds heated front seats, active bending headlight technology, electrically adjustable driver seat and a heated windscreen to a rather comprehensive package. Those wanting more exclusivity can opt for the first edition model, which comes with heated rear seats and steering wheel, keyless entry, a Harman Kardon stereo system, smartphone integration, wireless phone charger and a host of equipment packs found on the options list. Getting to grips with the Volvo XC40 outside? Willfully different to the Norman B, other Volvos, both of which is cool by me. In making it look like a tough little robot, apparently it most like, I guess, a Skoda Yeti, happy to be a bit blocky and earnest. There are neat touches, still. It about 25 millimeters wider at the back than the front, and there a ditty rubber Swedish flag hanging off the side of the bonnet, which is cute. Likewise inside, there are Volvo themes, the big, horizontal dash line, but here intercepted with bolder details, like novel air vents. Obviously, perceived material quality is lower than in more expensive.